बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल इन पाकिस्तान इंटरनेशनल स्कूल ताइफ वर्चुअल लर्निंग सिस्टम। टुडे इज आवर 55th वीडियो लेक्चर फॉर ग्रेड सेकंड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस एक्सरसाइज 6.6। बिफोर दिस एक्सरसाइज वी डिस्कस अबाउट एलिप्स, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ एलिप्स, हाउ टू फाइंड द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ एलिप्स फ्रॉम द इक्वेशन एंड हाउ टू फाइंड द इक्वेशन फ्रॉम द एलिमेंट्स एंड डिफरेंट कंडीशंस ऑन एलिप्स। नाउ वी विल स्टडी इन चैप्टर नंबर 6.6 हाइपरबोला। The standard summary of the standard hyperbola is given on page number 294. You can check it in your textbook. You have to memorize these standard forms. If the equation of the parabola and hyperbola and ellipse is approximately same, the difference is that in ellipse you have x square over a square plus y square over b square equal to 1. Here you have x square over a square minus y square over b square equal to 1. If ellipse hyperbola is along x-axis, then x square over a square, then x square value will be positive. If it is on y-axis, then y square value will be positive. It will be y square over a square minus x square over b square. If you check in ellipse, we change the position of a square and b square. You know that if it is on x-axis, so the major axis a square below x square. If it is on y-axis, then if a square is below y-axis. But here you have to change the position of xy. If it is on x-axis, then x square over a square minus y square over b square equal to 1. X value will be positive. If it is on y-axis, then y square over a square minus x square over b square equal to 1. Same is foci is same. If it is on x-axis, so plus minus c, 0. And if it is on y-axis, so 0 plus minus c. Directrix is also same. X equal to plus minus c over e square and y equal to plus minus c over a square. So transverse axis is, if it is on axis, so y equal to 0. If it is on y axis, x equal to 0. Vertices will be same, just like ellipse. If it is on x-axis, plus minus a, 0. If it is on y-axis, so 0 plus minus a. Eccentricity is also same, but here you have e equal to c over a greater than 1. And if you check in ellipse, you have given c over a is less than 1. Remember this. Sometimes in MCQs it will come. The eccentricity of the hyperbola is greater than 1 and eccentricity of the ellipse is less than 1 and hyperbola is equal to 1. Now center will be 0, 0. So we will start the exercise. Question number 1, first part, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th is included. And in question number 2, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7th, 8th included. And question number 3 and question number 6. Exercise 6.6, question number 1, you have given that find an equation of the hyperbola with the given data and sketch the graph of each. Just like 6.4, 6.5, you have given in first question elements and you have to find the equation. Here you have given the elements of hyperbola and you have to find the equation of hyperbola and you will sketch it. Center is given 0, 0 and focus is given 6, 0. 6, 0 show that the hyperbola is on x-axis because the value of x having some value, the value of y is 0, 0. Vertex is 4, 0. So means the value of a is 4, value of c is 6 and means that the hyperbola is on x-axis. For ellipse, you use c square equal to a square minus b square. For hyperbola, it is just slightly changed. C square equal to a square plus b square. So value of c, you have given 6. 6 square is 36. Value of a, you know that is 4. 4 square is 16. So b square, you can easily find it. 36 minus 16. So b square is 20. Also, axis is the transverse axis of the hyperbola, so y equal to plus minus under root 5 over 2x. So required equation will be what? X square over a square plus minus y square over b square, so x square over 16. Value of a is 4, so x square, a square is 16, y square over b square is 20, which is equal to 1. Now you have to draw with the given data the hyperbola. How? Focus is at 6, 0, so on x-axis positive 6, and on the other negative side, negative 6, you put that will be the focus. And for vertex at point 4 and here at minus 4. So with the help of this, you have to draw the hyperbola. Now after that, number 2 is not included. Number 3 is, foci is given 2 plus minus under root 5, plus minus 5 under root 2 and minus 7. And focus length of the transverse axis is 10. Means that transverse axis is 10. So 2a is equal to 10. So a is equal to 5. So now two focus are given. One is 2 plus under root 2 plus 5 under root 2 minus 7. Other is 2 minus 5 under root 2 minus 7. The value of y is constant and value of x changes. So it show that the hyperbola is on x-axis. So we find the distance between both focus, both foci. So f prime. Center, we find it by taking the midpoint of this xx value, we add divide by 2, yy value, we add divide by 2. So we get center 2 minus 7. Now, given that the transverse axis is length of transverse axis is 10, so a2 is equal to 10, a is equal to 5. So the distance between two foci, that is equal to 2c. That is equal to 2c. So we find the distance formula, x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. So we get 2c equal to 10 under root 2. So c is equal to 5 under root 2. Now c square equal to a square plus b square. So c square value is 50. A square value is 25 plus b square is also 25. Transverse axis is the along horizontal line. Y is equal to minus 7. So a is equal to 5. So vertices are 2 plus minus under root 5 minus 7 and 7 minus 7 and minus 3 minus 7. So we get the equation of hyperbola. How? X square over 2a square, that is 25, minus y square over b square, that is also 25, which is equal to 1. And you draw it from the given measurement. Fourth part, you will try to do it by yourself because it is just like the previous part. Foci is given and eccentricity is given. So from eccentricity, from foci, you have to find the value of c, and from eccentricity, you have to find the value of a. Fifth part is foci 0 plus 9 plus minus 9, directrix is y is equal to plus minus 4. So means that hyperbola is on y axis transverse axis is y axis, so c is equal to 9 and ae is equal to 9. C is equal to ae, so ae is equal to 9 and a over e equal to 4, so e is equal to 4, so we get 25/9 minus y square over b square, which is equal to 1. So b square value we get it from here. So 6th part, 7th and 8th, you try to do it by yourself in the same way. We have the elements are given, and with the help of elements you have to solve, and then you sketch the graph. Now come to question number 2. Question number 2 is find the center, foci, eccentricity, vertices and equation of the directrices of each of the following. You have given x square minus y square equal to 9. So make it 1, divide both sides by 9. We get x square over 9 minus y square over 9 equal to 1. Now a square and b square both having same value. 9, 9, so AB is 3, 3. C square we can find it, 9 plus 9, that is 18, so C is 3 under root 2. Center will be 0, 0, because nothing is added with x and y. And then you have to find, after center you have to find foci. Foci will be plus minus c0, so plus minus 3 under root 2, 0. Eccentricity is c over a, so 3 under root 2 over 3, that is under root 2. Vertices is plus minus a0, so plus minus 3, 0 value of a. Directrices is x equal to plus minus c over e square, so plus minus 3 under root 2 divided by 2. E is 3 under root 2 we get. Now the second part is x square over 4 y square over 9 equal to 1. It show that a square is 4, b square is 9, so a is 2 and b is 3. C square is a square plus b square, so that is under root 13 c. Center is 0, 0. Foci is plus minus c0, so plus minus under root 13, 0. Foci is under root 13, it is not 2, it is under root 13, 0. By mistake, it's written 2. Eccentricity will be c over a, under root 13 over 2, and vertices will be plus minus a0, so plus minus 2, 0. Directrices is x equal to plus minus c over e square, so plus minus under root 13, and that is 13 over 4 value of e square. So it will be 4 plus minus 4, because under root 13 and divide by 13, when we rationalize we get under root 13. So we find all the elements. Number 3 is not included. Number 4 is y square over 4. Number 4 is not included. Number 3 is just like number 2. You will try to do it by yourself. Number 5th is x minus 1 whole square over 2 minus y minus 1. Now this value you replace with capital X. This one value you replace with capital Y. So capital X is x minus 1. Capital Y is y minus 1. So a square is 2 and a is under root 2, and y b square is 9 and b is 3. For center 0, 0, capital X equal to 0, capital Y equal to 0. So that is C, we find it a square plus b square, so under root 2 plus 3. So that is a square plus b square, so 2 plus 9, that is 11. So C is under root 11. So value of x minus 1, x 1, and y is 1. So center is 1, 1. Now phi is plus minus c zero, so plus minus 11 under root 11 capital X, capital Y equal to zero. So you put capital X value minus 1, so 1 plus minus under root 11 and Y is 1. For eccentricity, c over a, so value of c is under root 11 and value of a is under root 2. And for vertices, plus minus a zero, capital X is plus minus under root 2 and capital Y is 0. You put value of capital X and value of capital Y, so you get center 1 plus minus under root 2 and 1. Equation of direct is capital X is plus minus C over E square. So C is A, E, E one time cancel. So A over E, A is under root 2 and E is under root 11 over 2. So under root 2 multiply with under root, that will be 2 under root 11. So capital X you replace with X minus 1, minus 1 shifted at other side, positive 1. So in this way we have to find the directrix value. Now come to sixth part. In sixth part, same just like fifth one. So sixth part is y plus 2 whole square divided by 9 minus x minus 2 whole square divided by 16. Now capital X you replace with y plus 2. This is on y axis. Capital X you replace with x minus 2 and capital Y you replace with y plus 2. So on y axis, so y is a square is 9, b square 16, so c square will be 9 plus 16, 25. So c is 5. Now for center, capital X equal to 0, capital Y equal to 0. So replace with x minus 2 and y plus 2, so we get 2 minus 2. For psi, it is on y axis because the value of y is positive. So 0 plus minus c, capital X equal to 0, capital Y plus minus 5. So x minus 2, put the value of x and put the value of y. So minus 2 shifted at other side, minus 2 plus 5 is 3. Minus 2 minus 5 is minus 7. So 2 for psi we get 2, 3 and 2 minus 7. Then eccentricity is equal to c over a. So c is 5 and a is 3, so 5 over 3. Vertices is 0 plus minus a, so capital X equal to 0, capital Y plus minus a. So again, capital X value we replace, capital Y value we replace, and value of a is plus minus 3. So 2 shifted at other side, so minus 2 plus 3 is plus 1, minus 2 minus 3 is minus 5. So 2 vertices, 2, 1 and 2 minus 5. Then equation of directrix y is equal to plus minus c over e square. So capital Y you replace with value of y, y plus 2, and c value is 5 and value of e is 5 over 3, so its square is 25 over 9, so 45 over 25. So 2 is positive here, shifted at other side, minus 2 plus minus 9 over 5. If you want to simplify, simplify it, otherwise up to this your question will be considered correct. Now 7th and 8th both having same method, so one I'll solve, discuss, and the second you will do it by yourself. 9x square minus 12x minus y square minus 2y plus 2. So what will we do? The constant we shifted at other side, the value of y we make it separate and the value of x we make it separate. So we take 9 common from this, so we get x square minus 4 over 3x, 12 over 9, and here y square plus 2y. To make the perfect square, what will we do? 2 over 3 whole square we added and subtracted, and here 1 we added and subtracted. So here we get the perfect square, x minus 2 over 3 whole square minus 4 over 9. So 9 when we multiply we get this, and similarly at this side we get y plus 1 whole square plus 1. Now the constant we shifted at other side and we get 1 here. Now to make it coefficient 1, we shifted in the denominator, so 1 over 9, and here minus this value over 1. Now we replace x minus 2 over 3 with capital X and y plus 1 with capital Y. So we get the center, we get a square is 1 over 9, a is 1 over 3, b square is 1. So b is 1, so c square is 1 over 9 plus 1, 10 over 9. And c is under root 10 over 3. So for center, capital X equal to 0, capital Y equal to 0, replace capital X value, X minus 2 over 3 value of Y, Y plus 1 equal to 0. So 2 over 3 Y equal to minus 1. So we get center this. For foci, capital X equal to plus minus C, capital Y equal to 0. So we replace its value and then shift it at other side. So we get this foci. And then for eccentricity, C over A under root 10 over 3 over 1 over 3, so it will be E equal to under root 10. For vertices, X equal to plus minus A, Y equal to 0, so you replace value of A and capital X value, so we get the vertex equation. This. Then, foci are this one. Equation of direct is X equal to plus minus C over E square. So replace the capital X value and C value and then E square, that is under root 10 square is 10. So we get this. So this is the equation of the direct is. Now come to question number 3. 8th, you will try it by yourself. Next two parts are not included, 9th and 10th. Question number 3 is, if you have this condition, 0 is less than A is less than C, then focus will be minus C0 and F prime will be C0. Be two fixed points, show that the point PXY such that this equal to this. So for PF, X minus minus plus C whole square plus Y minus 0 whole square Y square minus sign, and for PF prime X minus C whole square plus Y minus 0 so Y square plus minus 2A. Then this value which is subtracted shifted at other side, it will be added. Now squaring both side, just square root remove in the left hand side, in right hand side you have formula A plus B whole square, so that is 4a square plus this value square and plus minus 4a under root this. After that, if you check y square, c square and x square cancel from both side, we get this minus 2cx shifted at this side, it will be 4cx minus 4 of plus 4 is square shifted at this side, minus 4 is square. Now divide both sides by 4, we get this one. Now squaring both sides of 2, when we square we get c square x square minus 2a square cx plus a4, and here a square and this square root will remove. So a square multiply inside, so we get this. Now if you compare this minus 2a square cx and minus 2a square cx cancel with each other, we get c square x square plus a4 minus a square x square minus a square minus a square y square a square c square at this side. Now from here x square is common from these two value, we take it common, and a square y square, and here a square is common, so this a square into c square minus a square, divide on both sides, we get x square over a square minus y square over c square minus a square, which is equal to 1. This is the equation of the hyperbola and we prove it. Now come to question number 6. 6 is included, rest of the questions are not included. So question number 6 is this. Two listening points hear the sound of the enemy gun. The difference in time is 1 second if the listening points are 1400 feet apart. Write an equation of the hyperbola passing through the position of the enemy gun sound travel at 1080, means 1080 feet per second. Let two listening points will be the focus 1 and focus 2. Hear the sound at enemy gun after T and T minus 1 means that 1 second difference. So if one here with T second, so other one will with T minus 1 second respectively. Listening posts are how many distance apart? 1400 meter apart. So 2C means the distance between the center 2C is 1400. So C is equal to 700. If P is the position of the enemy gun, then the distance PF1 minus PF2 will be equal to 2A. So PF1 is 1080 into T and PF2 is 1080 into T minus 1. That is equal to 2A. So we get equation 2A is equal to, because this one cancel, 1080. So 2 divide on 1080, so A is 540. So B square we can find it because we know the C value, the A value. So we put it in B, C square minus A square. So that is the B square value. This equation of hyperbola will be X square over A square minus Y square over B square, which is equal to 1. So we put value and we get the equation of hyperbola. So this is the required answer. Required equation of hyperbola, we find it. Inshallah, next exercise 6.7, we will discuss in our next video lecture. Take care. Allah Hafiz.